It seems only fitting that we kick off a new season of this show with a story from Florida.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to the 2014 season of The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jonathan Paula. Today's story comes to us from Wesley Chapel, Florida. Yesterday afternoon, on January 13th, 71-year-old retired Tampa Bay police officer Curtis Reeves shot and killed Chad Oulson for texting on his cell phone at a movie theater. The victim, a 43-year-old family man, was there with his wife seeing the film, ironically, Lone Survivor. The film hadn't even started yet, though. The previews were still ongoing. The lights had not come down. He was texting his 3-year-old daughter, who I presume was still at home with a babysitter. Reeves got upset, an argument broke out, and rather than, you know, just pleasantly settling this, going to the manager, maybe coming to blows over it, Reeves takes out a concealed 38 caliber pistol and shoots him dead. The bullet also hit the wife, who's in the hospital tonight with non-critical injuries. Olson is dead. Reeves, under arrest for second-degree homicide. How does this even happen? I've been to the movie theater hundreds of times in my life. In fact, I'm going tonight to see The Wolf of Wall Street for movie night. Going to review it. Very excited about that. And I hope nobody in the theater is going to text or annoy me, because that would be an unpleasant experience for sure. But so unpleasant that I need to take out a weapon and murder them? I can understand getting into a fight, an argument. But really, you're going to put him in the ground over a stupid, small little problem, an inconvenience that only lasts a few moments. This is unexcusable and unjustifiable on anyone's part, let alone someone who used to be a police officer and should certainly know better. Now, perhaps the victim here had a totally reasonable excuse to be using a cell phone. He was texting his daughter. Maybe there was an emergency with the babysitter back home. He doesn't know until he checks. He wasn't given the benefit of the doubt and was killed over such a small, small issue, a minor inconvenience in anybody's life, at a screening of a Mark Wahlberg movie on a Monday afternoon matinee. Regretfully, I have to admit that I've used my cell phone at movie screenings before, but I try to keep the use to as little time as possible with the screen on the darkest possible setting and the vibration and the sound all the way down. But sometimes I have to use it for a few seconds, and I certainly hope the people behind me wouldn't kill me over it. Likewise, if someone uses their phone in front of me and bothers me, I give them a minute or two to shut it up on their own. If they don't, I'll politely ask them to stop. If they still don't, I'll go to a manager. I'm not going to kill them over it. It just seems so ridiculous that this would happen, and it's a tragic story in such bizarre circumstances. But that is Florida for you. The Grove 16 Cinema Complex does prohibit cell phone use in the theater, but it also prohibits gun use. So, let me know what your thoughts are on this story in the comments down below. But until next time, that is The World According to Me. My name is John. Thank you for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.